I'm TJ Manotok and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin with a new stunning U.S. Congressional Committee report which alleges that former President Donald Trump violated the U.S. Constitution's Emoluments Clause by getting more than $7.8 million in payments from other countries and their leaders. The report by the Committee on Oversight and Accountability from the Democratic staff identifies the Philippines along with China, Saudi Arabia, Malaysia, and others as countries that spent lavish in apartments, hotel stays, and events at Trump properties. Page 113 of the report showed that in June 2018, Manila's embassy in Washington, D.C. paid nearly $75,000 for a Philippine Independence Day celebration and reception at the Trump International Hotel in Washington, D.C. This came at a time when the Philippines was seeking a free trade agreement with the U.S., which the Trump administration did not eventually enter into with Manila. The report says then-President Trump showed eagerness to foster close ties with then-President Rodrigo Duterte, even as the latter was criticized for his bloody war on drugs. Philippine Ambassador to the U.S. Jose Manuel Romualdez told ABS-CBN News that he already addressed the issue in 2018 and has no further comment. But in a June 2018 interview, Romualdez said this,
"It may sound like a political statement, but maybe it is. It's being held at the Trump Hotel, with the President of the United States happens to have the same name as this hotel." So,
in other news, tens of millions of Americans in the Northwest and Midwest are bracing for wicked weather conditions, with snowstorms and flooding threatening the East Coast. Airlines canceled or delayed more than 3,600 flights across the U.S. on Friday, including planes grounded at Chicago's O'Hare International Airport due to winds and blinding snow. In the Midwest, people are dealing with blizzard-like conditions, featuring heavy snow and fierce winds of up to 60 miles per hour that were expected to continue into Saturday, the National Weather Service warned. Longtime Filipino residents of Chicago say they're used to the snowy and wet weather but are taking some steps to stay safe.
"I just make sure that I'm wearing layers if I'm going outside, if I'm inside, making sure that the pipes are running with water so that they don't burst."
"Definitely just try to stay inside. Usually a lot of things are canceled, schools, sometimes, depending on where your job is, of course, sometimes those, you know, people can work from home."
And finally, in sports, a record-setting deal for history-making Filipino-American NBA head coach Eric Spoelstra. The Miami Heat has signed Coach Spoelstra to an 8-year, $120 million extension. The $120 million is the most money ever committed to a North American coach of any pro sport. Since taking over as head coach in 2008, the 53-year-old Spoelstra has led the Heat to 6 NBA Finals, winning 2 championships, and is currently in 19th place when it comes to all-time coaching wins. Spoelstra addressed the contract extension shortly before Wednesday night's home game against the Oklahoma City Thunder, showing appreciation for the franchise's owners and leaders who have stuck with him for nearly 30 years.
"It's very humbling, you know, to be able to have that kind of continued stability, you know, and then, you know, basically, you know, for the staff as well, you know, that we can wrap our minds around, you know, the foreseeable future."
And those are the stories making the headlines. For more of our TFC News, log on to our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News. Head over to our YouTube channel of the ABS-CBN News channel and download the ABS-CBN News app for your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manotok. Stay with us, Kapamilya.